アホ面でギラついてんじゃねえよ。
It's actually been quite interesting watching Tenrai play today, both of them as a matter of fact. Tenrai decided to switch it up a little bit and go with Bulbasaur instead of his Angie. But he's actually been doing alright, he's not been doing too badly at the moment. Still finding it hard, but he's still doing quite well. And it's actually quite good seeing people using Bulbasaur's Force Break. Not many people do, well not over here anyway. See that he's getting those FRCs down. Really good for applying pressure with Bulbasaur. Oh, he gets the overhead. I know that Apollo's been having some difficulty with some of Aino's FRCs. Oh, and he gets thrown into the corner, and that would have been guaranteed off anyway. So tomorrow we've got quite a lot of other games going on as well, including Injustice, King of Fighters, Street Fighter as well. And some more Shonen Burst Madness going on as well, so Persona, BlazBlue, etc, etc. What's that?
Are you? Alright, safe man.
Yeah, alright, safe man. Yep, yeah, there's Marvel today. Quite a few of these guys. You know what, yeah? Yeah, White Black is here. He's here at the moment. He literally walked in about half an hour ago. Before that, all these guys were just sitting down, not really too sure what to do. And they wanted to chill out as well and wait for a bit later because of the MCM. So to be fair, because they all wanted to chill out, whatever, innit? I know that Kaiser and Kappa are on the way down now. And I know that White Black was actually asking about Kaiser in particular. So I think there might be a match going on between them a bit later. So let's see what happens. They're staying overnight as well. As a matter of fact, quite a few guys are staying here overnight. So yeah, it should actually be a good one. It's going to be quite busy. Oh man, if Kaiser comes down, I'll be one of the first to rinse his Robo Kai on this game. You know. So they're both one round apiece. Pretty much all over the place here. But it's cool, they're both new players. They're both learning the game. And they're not starting off too badly at all, so that's cool. There's an immediate burst there. Smart one as well, I don't think he wants to lose any more health. And I think he was actually going for another Force Break there. Bulbasaur, anyway. Aino's doing her bit to keep her distance. Oh, and she got him there but couldn't follow on the combo. Gold burst as well, so that's full bar. Yeah, gun flame, and that's it. That's first match to True 10, right? What's up, man? Huh? Yep, it's still there. It's match number two. Hey, Mr. Tenrai is on a bit of a roll now, so he's going to want to try and finish this as soon as he can. Gets the knockdown. Let's see what his mix-up's going to be. Oh, he gets thrown. He should be... Nah. I was telling Tenrai that he should just go straight for jumping heavy slash into dust. Just to stop the scaling. Oh, wow. Nice blocking there, but gets tripped up. Steve should be looking for... He should be looking for more air throws here, but... He doesn't get it. And instead, he eats a jumping heavy slash dust, which does take a lot. Gets the knockdown. Oh, wow. Nice basic combo there. Not guaranteed you can wiggle out of it, but it does take a bit of effort. Counter. it's cool, Rakurai, man. You're down here most of the time anyway, so it's all good. Sorry guys, I'm just gonna test this mic out a piece. Test. That's a good bell. A true Tenrai beats Apollo. Knocking him into the losers. Hey Chris.
Yo Chris. Well, you got everything, yeah? Have you got everything? Hey yo, kid. Okay, first kid.
Next, we got Ope versus Kitsch, Dr. No. Two new play. Oh, sorry. One sec, guys. Wrong with these guys. Yeah, so Chrome just walks through the door just to come and say hi. Surprisingly, Kitsch's Potemkin is a lot better than he was a while ago. He's definitely put the time and effort in. Kind of knows what to go for, but still having difficulty. And Ope Slayer isn't that bad, improving all the time, so a bit more comfortable playing this game. Kitsch should be looking for the heavy knockdown. Oh, lovely play there. Gets the heavy knockdown. Gets the overhead there, but couldn't finish the link. And now he's in the corner. Let's see if Kitsch can keep him there. Nah, he's going to teleport forward there. He's dropping a lot of links there, but... yeah, gets him that time. One round apiece. See if Kitsch can pull this back. See if he can stay in this game. What's happening, man? You don't need to, man. Go on.
Hello?
Yeah,
no, I can't. Oh, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can.
Oh, I'm just about here, yeah, safe.
What, seriously?
Just about. Can you turn my head a little bit up?
Wait a sec. Wait a...
oh, shit. Slayer combos. Running, man.
Yep.
Hard knockdown. Overhead.
And he's getting all of those links now. Force break. Oh, look at the
damage.
Where's
the pawn drive special?
And that's Potemkin, and Potemkin has... He has a load of health. If you ever watch this game and you see a lot of health coming off of Potemkin, then you know that it's a lot of health. Wow.
Wow, and, the Marvel guys are going nuts over there.
And Kitsch is actually happy. Yeah, no, they got guys over there to play at the moment. we should be getting a little bit of Marvel later.
What's the guy's name from France?
White Black, yeah.
White, it's White Black, isn't it?
That's the name, man.
I thought you said White Man.
No, White Black. Oh, God. Yeah, so...
I'd like to try and see if those guys could get, like, some first attempts against White Man. Against White Black, sorry, later on.
Yeah. No, I think they will be. Oh, and Kitsch changes colour after his win.
Yeah, man.
Force break. Yeah, smart burst.
For some reason, I'm desperate on seeing the pawn drive special of just double overhead.
Yeah.
For no reason. Let's go.
No, that double overhead was quite sick. And Dr. No takes that one. Quite convincingly as well.
Yeah. Oh, shit.
I think he was just a little bit upset about that last loss.
Yeah.
Oh, how long? I'd say judging right now, maybe about 45 minutes to an hour, maybe.
And then you'll probably be less than that, depending on how quickly we go through.
You'll probably end up seeing some matches then.
We're streaming all the matches. We're putting all the matches on stream, right?
We've got
some setups around here that's not being used really.
Yeah, no, we'll stream as much as we can. But this is actually one of the tournaments, so we'll have this on now.
Right.
I think after this game, it's going to be Marvel.
Yeah, and that would be cool. Yeah, and then Tekken us.
Yeah, then after that, it will be Tekken.
What's up, Lee?
Yeah.
Yeah. Huh?
Oh, well, just after this, I'll just send him over to you. Yeah?
Yeah, no, I'm actually interested to see what's going to happen with Marvel now that White Black is here anyway.
Yeah.
I mean, regardless of what you think of his level, he's still one of those players, and it's still interesting to see what's going to happen. Yeah. So, you know.
And it's always interesting to see people from, like, you know, in the UK, you know?
Yeah, no, I was going to say something. I said, yeah, it would be an opportunity for, like, you know, like the UK heads to look at his tech.
Yeah.
Before tomorrow, yeah?
Before tomorrow, yeah.
You know? Ah, it's good to see them supporting still. And to be honest, once he walked through the door, it kind of gave a little bit of life to Marvel.
It did,
you know.
It's surprising, like, one guy outside the UK, you know.
Yeah, no, it is.
It becomes important.
No, it's good for those guys, man. They need more people from outside coming down here every so often to play them on games, you know?
Probably it's not going to happen for a long time, but obviously everyone would like to see the Americans come down here, you know, show us a thing or two on Marvel.
Yeah, no, of course.
But again, that's just me probably being a fanboy.
I wouldn't say that.
Oh, did you put on the Empire that the stream's up?
Don't. No. Wait, that's it.
Wow, does Kitsch win that game? Nah, it's 1-0.
Yeah, it's 1-0 in this round, but if Kitsch wins this, then he's knocked okay into the losers.
Yeah. Running, man. Eating that sweep. Kitsch applying some nasty pressure. Oh, wants that back dash Potemkin Buster. The cheap stuff. Wow, that flick has rage. Nice. Here he goes reflector. Nothing. Oh, this could actually be death. Nah. Misses the combo. Oh shit. Oh, you should have RC'd. Oh no, you're on the bar, RC's the move. Let's go. Oh! Box!
And that's... Oh yeah, sorry, no. Yeah, that's it. And Ope walking away, just cussing about Potemkin. Oh no, he's too tough, man. Hate him. But to be fair to Potemkin, in this game, he's really good.
Yeah,
you know,
yeah.
He's really, really good.
I hear he's quite good in plus R as well. not as good as when he was in Accent Core, but I hear good things.
Nah, he is good, man. All right, so next we've got I know you don't want that. I have to call him.
Hey Zato, it's you versus Tenrai.
Oh, I really feel sorry for this guy, an Eddie player, and you're a new guy as well. No, look, I wouldn't do it. Yeah, I really wouldn't do it, man. I wish you luck, man. I wish you all the luck. Wait, you want to jump on? All right, safe. Yeah, so Zato's a little bit of an OG player. He's been playing this game for a long time, and he's good. So you could tell he hadn't played the game for a while today. He was dropping a lot of stuff, but boy, it's not really gonna make much difference, man. You're gonna see unblockables. You're gonna see it all here. There we go. Yep. couldn't follow it up, right? Goes back into the corner. And you know those things are just there to keep you in place, man. Let's see if he can follow the combo. Oh, no, he can't. When you fight a person like Zato, I'm talking about the actual player, not the character. It's like, when you get an opportunity to hit a character like that, then, you know, you just want to hit him. What's happening, man? Wagwan. Yeah, man. Oh, he gets that perfect dust. Oh, no, does he? Kind of. Almost had it there. It was all right still. Let's see if this is going to end up in some kind of unblockable. And the thing is, once he throws out those little spiral things, you're really scared to move, because when they hit you, you're just on the floor. And that's it. That's first match to Zato. What? I should fill out this bracket already. Just, yeah, safe, yeah? You know? Why is Finch always trolling? Nah, he's changed his character now, man. He's not doing Angie anymore. That's the one. See what I mean? Those things keep you in place. And you know, like, the Soul has a smaller jump. So, you know, he's going to want a big jump air dash out of that pressure if he can. Caught him out with it there. And he is going to be... Oh, no, he bursts. No, you know why? Because he knew what was coming next. That's why. Floor. Yep. You're not going to escape that. And this... I mean, I've played Zato a handful of times and I was angry immediately, you know. But still not as angry as fighting Biken. Well, that's it. That's a wrap. I swear Tenrai don't want to get up. It's a good match, man. You need the experience. Still. Porn Driver just screaming at him, you're a skank. Porn Driver was just screaming at Zato, you're a skank. You know.
Porn Driver, you versus
Obey. Alright, so we got Porn Driver and Obey next. Dr. No. Oh, wait there, sorry. Yeah, go on, sorry.
Nah, I was saying, I feel violated, man. I think I need to, like, see a counsellor for, like, you know, a few weeks.
I just don't like the fact that, like, Zato's just over there smiling to himself. He's just proper chilling.
Oh, I'm so upset.
Nah, when you fight a character like Eddie, that's the kind of war you're getting in for, you know?
Yeah.
It's not going to be an easy one.
I need to read up on that guy, because I just don't know.
I'll be honest here, when he gets you on the floor, there's nothing to know. It's yeah. just either you're going to burst out of his unblockable or you're just going to get to the unblockable. That's it. I mean, to be fair to that character, even though it's still his teeth, but...
I know it's quite hard
it's
to use.
Quite difficult it's to quite, use. Yeah. But, you know, he's been using that character for a while, so... You just have to try and not get yourself in that predicament, man.
Try not get hit.
Oh, wow, some fabulous combos shit. Here. It's wow, look at Slayer's health. Now, again, Slayer has probably got, was it the second or third most health in the game? You see how much he lost? Now, if that was on chip...
It'd be off.
Probably. That would have probably been 90%. Right, he's actually not having it. He's all business. Yeah, he's all business. Yep, they're all here, man. They're all here. Yeah, sorry, at Docker, though. Yeah, they're all here, man. You know, I don't understand. I knew this was going to happen today, but whatever, innit? It's like, I got to a certain stage, and all of a sudden, people just wouldn't stop coming in. You know?
Yeah.
But it's cool, though. You know, the more the merrier. It's all about getting those good games in.
Yeah. Oh.
So, yeah, after this is done, then we're going to have a little bit of Marvel.
Wow.
And then after Marvel, it's going to be Tekken. You know what I want to do? I want to start getting some ST tournaments on the go, man.
I know, I saw.
I need to play that game. Just to pick T-Hawk, of course.
Yeah, of course.
And our first match goes to Pawn Driver. Huh? Oh, sorry. Give me 1 second. And Pawn Driver's definitely not making it easy for OP.
Throwing them 2 P's. Oh. Oh, good best. Oh, this is done. Ooh, OP clutched it out.
Yeah. Well, to be fair to OP, he's managing to keep with him.
Yeah.
But, I mean, Pawn Driver has so much more experience.
But you know what? These two have been at it all day.
I've seen it. Oh, wow. Again, as I said, when you see a lot of health coming off of Slayers, wow.
Oh, that's when you know a combo's fucked.
Oh, he went for that air dash combo, but just couldn't get it on him.
Ooh.
Let's see, because you know, like, against Johnny, those combos are different because he's a heavier character. He gets...
This is possibly death.
Oh, wow.
Oh, shit.
Wow. And Tano manages to bring that back. That's one apiece.
Yeah.
That was only ever going to be 2-0, yeah?
Allow it, man.
All right. I think you did all right against him, though. Like, regardless.
I don't think I did.
You did, man.
I need to watch a lot more order cell videos just to see what's up.
Yeah.
Because I'm not getting his mint up now.
I mean, I tell you, the thing that annoys me about Johnny most of the time is his weight class.
Yes. That's combos. The combos that does just... Like, it's not even how Johnny plays, really, because, you know, Johnny's a fundamentally solid character. But it's just the fact that nothing works on him.
Yeah, that's true. I can't believe Ope actually used his burst there.
Yeah.
Yeah, Albert.
That was,
I probably would have just taken the death.
He's probably desperate to try and... Well, it was either desperate or just incredibly pissed off at what he was saying.
Of course, yeah.
Oh. Hard knockdown.
That's the thing, like, when people play against a character like Slayer, they just don't want the hard knockdown.
Yeah.
But you play a character like Millie or Rage, like, once you get knocked down, then, you know, yeah. You actually have to be a wizard to get out of her mix-ups.
Oh, a wolf link. Oh.
Box. Oh, wow, it gets the Superman punch. Nah.
Oh, good blocks. That's that.
Yeah. And that's games to Pawn Driver.
So who's next? Is it... it's Apollo Steve versus Kit, right? You know, later on, after...
In a sec, alright. I'm coming over in a minute.
After all the tournaments are done, you should look on streaming KO for the rest of the night.
Oh, I'd love to, man. We'll see what happens, innit? Because I know that selected mans would like to see that. But
yeah.
It's just... Alright, so... Alright. So we're going to go to the loser's bracket now. And,
Okay. Okay. Versus Apollo Steve. Wait, Apollo. No.
Oh, man. Oh, God, I guess I'm... Potemkin.
Well, the thing is, all right, for you, you're using a new character, so that's where the difficulty comes in.
Yeah.
Yeah? So...
I might consider using Angie for that one.
Maybe. Maybe. You'd probably do a lot better if you did. I'm just taking burials, you know what I mean? Oh, man. Hey, whoa. I'll not forget that happened, because it didn't. It was cold. It's just that they, you know what just happened, yeah? It's just that they're twins, yeah? So you go up and you speak to one of them, and he's like, yeah, I want to enter this tournament. And it's like, all right, cool. And then you go back up to him later and say, so what? I'm putting you in this tournament, yeah? And he's like, nah, it's cool. And then the other one comes up to you and says, look, man, why am I not in the tournament? And it's like, oh, all right, I'm safe. wins.
Yeah.
I feel so bad now. Oh wow.
Oh, I thought I was going to double over there.
Yeah, wait, I gotta change these names over quickly. Yeah, sorry about that. Yes, yeah, so this is True Apollo Steve versus Dr. No. That's what people don't like, it's that. They just don't like the fact that he can do that and then they have to think about it.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah.
And if you do it right, it's actually quite difficult to get around for the simple fact that he's at a range where you can't throw him.
Yes.
You know, most of the time.
And most
look at this guy, man. Look, Shino. Seriously, man. Just go away, man. Like that, man. It's you see, if he comes over, he's like, look, man, what's this?
Shout out to Shino.
What is wrong with this guy? That's first match to Mr. No. What's up,
Mr.
man?
Mr. No.
What's up?
I said it's 4G, you know.
It's pretty good from right here.
It's decent, man. I got to thank a selected friend for that. I'll keep his name quiet, otherwise people be like, oh, look, man, hook me up. And that's the thing, Steve doesn't have any problems with his maneuvering. His maneuvering's actually quite good, if I know. It's just the combos. Oh, wow. And that's
I know combos are hard.
Yeah.
Like, proper hard.
Well, the last person I remember using I know to any level was Rizzo.
Right.
The last person. As a matter of fact, his I know is really annoying.
Yeah.
Really, really annoying.
Oh. Long grab.
And Ope is just handing out the pressure.
Oh, that's left.
I think he's... he gets a gold burst now. Let's see what he can do with the bar. Superman punch. And Ope takes that one.
Right.
So Steed has been knocked out. Oi, Steed.
Oi, Steed. Go and feed your cats, man, and hurry up.
Oh, so the next match is True Tenrai versus Kitsch. Let's see where Kitsch is at.
Hey, where's Kitsch at? Hey, Kitsch, you know? Huh? I don't know. Yeah, but I don't like him. Hold on. I took the time. No. I had to.
It's some greedy guys, man. Seriously. Oh, well, look, man, you're going to be up against Zato in a second. Yes, it is. I just have a feeling that James was going to sit down there and just start rinsing games and we wouldn't be able to get him off. See you in a set, man. Don't be naughty. Okay, yeah, sorry. Yeah, the next match is good old True Tenrai versus Kitch. Kitch is over there playing Tekken, I believe. Just 1 second, guys. Sorry. Alright, so we're ready to kick this match off. Let's see, this should be upside daisy, wrong way around. Character, as I said before, for Tenrai, but Kitch has actually been getting a hell of a lot better with his Potemkin. So let's see, this should be quite interesting. An early burst there, so he doesn't have that to rely on anymore. 1 thing I'll give Kitch is that he's actually very patient with Potemkin's grab. Doesn't really go for it that often. He's losing a lot of health here. How you doing, man? Yeah. HD Clutch just coming over to tell me that he's in the winners' final. So, yeah, we will actually be having Marvel here very soon. I'm sure SY and Chris will come over here and fill me in with all the details to tell me who's where and what. That was a little bit too far for that super. Should have been a bit closer just to keep him on the floor. He should be rinsing that slide head just a bit more. There we go. He's got to try his best to keep Ordisol on the floor. What's up, man? Okay. Oh, gold burst there. And he's got his entire bar. Let's see what he can do. Nah, that was a little bit too low. Or the soul should have been a bit higher. What's up, man? Yeah. All right, how far are we in the Marvel? All right, cool. Huh? What, you want to jump on commentate on this? Do you know anything about this? All right, so... All right, okay, cool. Okay, so Oso is here with me.
What's good? And whatever I don't know, you can teach me, innit? I'm here to learn.
As long as you're not going to start asking me anything technical about this game, the only person who could probably answer that is either Rizzo or maybe Rizzo. Maybe Finches is a man.
I'm only just starting, man. It's still baby steps, so...
Who are you using?
Huh? Mate, Jam. But oh, I want to start learning ABBA.
Man.
I want to learn ABBA afterwards.
Oh, look, man, right? I might have to take you off commentary, man. Jam. Oh, man.
Bro, how many characters in this game aren't hated? Like, let's be real. Every time anybody brings up any character, they're like, bun that character.
All right, now, Eddie, he's dry, yeah. He's super dry, but he's got unblockables, but he's kind of honorable.
Yeah, yeah.
If you know what I mean. He's still honorable.
Okay.
Right? Jam. Sometimes he hits you with a puffball, you're in the corner and you're losing everything.
I've seen that wall.
No, if you want high damage combos, yeah. That are a little bit easier to do, then yeah. Jam is your woman. That's
Yeah.
You know, I can't take that away from her. I'd say with Jam, it's not a case of hate. It's more a case of, oh, do I have to? It's like, oh. The only character in this game that is literally hated. I mean, hated where...
Potemkin.
No.
No?
Potemkin's not hated. I mean, he's teeth like at high level, but he's not. He's not like,
okay.
You know, he's Baikon.
Oh yeah, because she comes out of block stun, isn't it?
No. Look, don't say she comes out of block stun. Just say she comes out of her block. That's it. You know?
Yeah, that does seem kind of cheap.
It's just dry. She basically has alpha counters all the time. It doesn't cost any bar. And she can cancel it if she has bar and then give you a combo. That's it. Because the thing about that character is that every character in this game has to play against her differently.
Yeah, everyone.
You know?
Yeah, that's the nature of, like, matchups, isn't it? Like, everyone's got to play a bit different, but...
Yeah, but she kind of does
But you can't touch her, though. That's the thing, I guess.
She's super dry, man.
Yeah.
But then, don't get me wrong. At the same time, we've never had to put up with, like, a really high-level Milia.
Yeah.
I reckon if we had to put up with a high-level Milia, I reckon nobody would want to play that character. We'd all say she was busted. Because as soon as she hits you down to the floor and she throws out the disc...
Oh yeah, you can't see, innit? You can't see. Like, it's a 5-frame overhead or
something. It's not that you can't see, it's just that you have to sit down and eat whatever she's going to give you.
Yeah, kind of sounds like Marvel, though, to be honest.
But it's like, all right, think about getting the worst ambush you could get in Marvel, but you're only getting it from one character.
That does sound kind of deep.
It's just one of those games, man. You know, with Baikon, you're going to get that hit.
Yeah, that's it.
You know, and I know How to Read was saying to me, oh, you know, he'd consider him, blah, blah, blah.
Oh, and he was talking about playing Milia as well, innit?
So that's True Ten right through, and Kitch has been knocked out. That's unfortunate because I actually like his Potemkin. Because the thing about him, he literally went from being a player that didn't know too much at all.
And then
1 week we were chatting to him and it was like, nah, man, do this and do that. And dude, yeah, he looks a bit upset. He's like, do this and do that. And then like the next week he came back and he was doing a lot.
You know
what I mean? And I was like, well, okay, you know, this is cool.
So someone that's actually improving
he is improving a lot. So yeah, now it's OP. Dr. No versus Tenrai.
Slayer, yeah? Versus Older Soul.
Yes. And this should be an interesting match. I think it was... what is this guy doing?
I don't know, man. OP took his stick off for a minute.
Yeah.
They're on other sides. They're on opposite sides now, I think.
Yeah.
But it's sick though, like the one thing that I love about this game is the fact that so many characters are so unique.
Yes.
Everybody plays different. It's like
they're not even supposed to be in the same game together. Yeah. Everyone's got their own mechanic, and that's I think that's sick.
That's what it feels like. Definitely, yeah. Everyone is different. You know? It's like lots of different games all just shoved into one, but they kind of made it work. It's got a very smart system. So,
yeah.
You know, hold on, just one second. I want to go and chat to Chris quickly.
Oh, let me take this off. I don't know if they're starting or what. Wait, is that the intro? My God, I've never seen this intro. It looks sick. Heaven or hell, let's rock. All right. Slayer seems like a really slow character to me. I mean, like, not so much slow, but very deliberate in what you have to do. And he seems kind of sick because he just seems like that high damage kind of done. And then Order Soul is just going nuts, just going left, right. Respect. I'm commentating, man.
Yeah, sorry about it. Yeah, yeah. With
yo, is Slayer a high damage guy?
Yeah, well, he's got a lot of health.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
And he dishes out, like, you know.
Like, I've seen people like just combo off that super where he just like clocks you from like top of the screen.
Yeah, because once he does it, then he can carry on. As a matter of fact, from both of his supers, if he does like the Superman punch, it sticks you on the wall.
Yeah.
And then he gets a combo. If he's close enough.
That's nuts. So I'm guessing not too many characters in this game can combo off supers like that.
Some can.
Yeah. But not too many.
I got to think about it. Oh, wow. Kim's here.
And Order Soul just charges up his moves. Does shit like that.
He can charge up his moves and he can store them, make his moves a bit stronger. And you know, it's like the properties of all of his moves change. Like sometimes it will be a knockdown, or sometimes it will help with a juggle and things like that.
He seems really similar to Ragnar for me, like more so than regular Soul.
In places, yeah. Ooh. As long as you know that Order Soul was around first, yeah?
Yeah. All right, then. Of course.
Because Ragnar is slightly waste.
Yeah. But the whole game, like, not the game itself, but the characters, I actually think they're kind of washed compared to
BlazBlue.
Yeah. Compared to Guilty Gear characters, like, just design-wise, I don't like it.
I suppose it's because they look a bit more cartoony. Like, you see, like, with the characters in this, if you look at them closely,
they are a little bit Western in design. Yeah, like, they're not, even the names and everything.
You know, like big eyes and big heads and all this stuff. Like, you don't really see it here as such.
But yeah, like, BlazBlue, it felt like they were trying to cater to the anime crowd too much, you know what I mean? So,
you know what? I'll be honest with you. Like, lately, I've actually I can't remember what we were saying now.
Yeah, they are. They are Habu.
Yeah, they are. Axl Rose.
Yeah, obviously. That's like the most obvious one. But even like their special moves as well, isn't it? Like, Kai's got a super called Ride the Lightning or something.
Yeah. So, well, it's all music for them, isn't it?
Yeah. Like, I think that's the name of like a Metallica album or something. You know?
Hey, so what, have you lot been over there, like, scoping that Rare Tactics?
What?
White, black?
Nah, I haven't really. Like, the thing is, right? What's strange about White Black isn't so much that he is this kind of player that has like bare tricks and everything, yeah?
Yeah.
Bruv, he is just pure solid fundamentals. He plays so... Oh, I gotta go play, yeah?
All right, one second. Hey, Chris. Yeah, nah, that's cool. I just had to clear that up for you guys because I don't want to hear no noise just in case these not run the entire tournament and we get no Marvel here, because I know who will be making noise. But yeah, as it stands, we'll get the winner's final, loser's final, and grand final on stream. I'm not sure who's going to be in it, but we'll see when it gets there anyway. Oh, that's going to hurt. Nah, he doesn't get it. Oh, and that's two games. to Dr. No. So now we're going to go for the winner's final.
Hey, Zato. Born driver.
Okay, so this is the winner's final for Guilty Gear. Oh no, Kitch, what was... Hey Kitch, what, was you slightly upset about your loss to Tenray?
No, I'm just tired.
Alright, safe. Yeah. No, because you look like you wanted to like smash him into pieces. No, but your Potemkin is getting a lot better now, man. It really, really is. It's good stuff, man. At least you're using forward and punch now, yeah? That's important, man. Can't let people jump into you. So let's see what happens there. This is a very old school match. These lot have been having this match now for a good few years now. Both players know each other quite well. They used to hang around in the GG community. Well, since about maybe 2007. So they know each other quite well. And Porton Driver has a very good Johnny. Look at the damage, man. Wow. Gets the forward and punch, but he bursts. He wants none of that. Zato's been being put under a lot of pressure here, but I think he's going to go for an unblockable with Eddie. That's what he's going to be setting him up for. Yeah. Porton Driver wanted to avoid that. Tried to jump out of the way, and he loses a lot of health in return. He's going to go for a cancel throw, and he gets it. Yeah. It's just important for Porton Driver to remember. He's got to not so much stay in the air, but he's got to be a little bit wary of little Eddie. Trying to keep himself at that perfect range. He goes for the burst. He wants none of it there. That was a smart choice. And he's still got a lot of health, so it's all right. Misses the misfinder. Zato has lost a lot of health. Let's see if he can bring this back somehow. And he's lost little Eddie as well. Goes for a burst. Oh. And Porton Driver almost made that look quite easy. Almost. Let's see if he can just get into the swing of things. What are you saying, Tenors?
Not much, man. Just... Oh.
Huh?
Not much. Just chilling now, I guess, for a little bit.
This is a bit of a classic match here for me.
It is, yeah. You know,
as I said, these guys have been having this match for about 6 years. it's been a while, man. Immediate burst. You see, as soon as that character starts to put anyone under pressure, they just don't want any of it. As soon as you let him do it, then you're going to get that unblockable. It's going to happen. But when you have no burst,
then it's, yeah.
And Porton Driver's doing a really good job with the forward and punch. Ooh. There is an anti here. Wow, he's getting those combos in.
Season. Wow. He's got them down. Level 2.
And he's on level 3. No,
level 3. Oh,
yeah, he gets it. Wow.
Throwing them 2p coins.
It's going to be interesting to see if there's a character change a bit later on from Zato.
Possibly, yeah. Who else do you play? I know he plays quite a lot of characters, but... Oh, he plays Angie as well. That's his second. That's his guy who's been playing a lot recently. Oh, gets the dust.
And he pulls it back there. I actually thought he, you know, you can never count Eddie out, man.
Never, yeah.
Little Eddie.
Yep.
Went for a throw there, but missed it.
How long can Eddie fly for?
I'm not sure. Couple seconds, maybe. All right, he gets the throw and he puts Johnny in the corner. Oh no! Ooh. What happened there? Oh, and he goes for the mist. And he gets the gold burst, so he's got a full bar now. Let's see if he can keep him on the floor. What's going on here?
Wow, what?
He's just, oh wow. And he had to burst there because he knew what was coming. And this is what he wants to do. Oh, and he gets the dust and almost got the impossible dust combo there. You know what? I can't do those things at all.
I can do some of them. I can do Angie's one.
Oh, wow. He got the level 2 misfinder there, but he couldn't make it in time to scoop him off the floor.
Yeah.
Oh, wow, and he throws a coin at little Eddie. Ah, that was unfortunate, and that's one apiece. Zato is still in there.
Yeah.
Now, if this match comes round again, then, you know. I know Ope's in the top three as well, so I get to see some of Ope Slayer again. I don't know why, but when I see that Eddie, it just, oh.
Oh. The command grab, the puddle.
Yeah, I think he wanted to try and delay it a bit because he was expecting him to try and get out of it, but. And he calls out Eddie and he goes for the burst immediately. He's not having any of it. Oh, wow. Let's see what's going to happen here. And he bursts. Lovely combo. Look at the health.
Wowzers.
Yeah. Off the floor ever so slightly. When you're doing Senga at that level, it's an overhead. So if anyone sits down, they're going to get hit by it. And I do like the way Pawn Driver is using the coins against little Eddie.
Yeah, yeah.
He's actually smart. Using those coins to get rid of him, which is very smart. And he gets the throw.
Nice grab.
He wanted to go for a coin so he could throw out the misfinder and just bounce him off the wall a few times. Oh, wow. And Zato actually has another burst as well.
Ooh.
Oh, and he gets over the super. And he bursts. Oh.
Bad burst.
Actually match to Pawn Driver. Knocking Zato into losers. Stay on the machine. Yeah. So they go straight into this match now. I know he's, because Dr. No doesn't really know as well. I think this is the first time he's ever had to put up with an Eddie player, so
right.
He's just learning the ropes.
What's wrong? Hey Sim, where did my bottle of water go?
I don't know, man.
Oh, well, I left it here.
Maybe, well, what? Was it the big one?
Yeah. Oh, there it is. Safe.
Look, man. Move this dirty thing away, man.
What do you mean, man?
Oh, let's see if it's going to be unblockable time. Yep.
Yep.
See, that's the thing. It's just that, like, against Pawn Driver, you know, he's got a little bit more experience against it. So he'll try his best to, you know, dash out of it and all kinds of things. So I'm actually not that bad against Johnny because I used to be a Johnny player. But against a character like Eddie, there's none for me. When I play him, I just don't have a clue. Look. He's chipping away at Slayer's bar. Tried to range him there with the dust, but he didn't have enough.
Ooh,
oh, wow.
Combo.
Look at the health. That's lovely.
Oh, this is death.
Yep.
Yeah,
nice that
work.
Was smart. Hope's actually stepped up his game a little bit.
Yeah.
I like the way he was getting those links. It's like, if you're looking at what he's doing, you know, it looks kind of easy, but Slayer doesn't have chain combos on the floor.
Yeah.
It's all links.
All links.
All of it.
I tried it myself, it's hard.
And Slayer is one of those characters that has a lot of health as well, so it's either the second or the third. It's between him and or the Soul.
Right.
And that's the first match to Zato. Just if you don't know a lot about Eddie, it's really hard to fight against him.
Yeah.
Gets rid of little Eddie, but he's on the floor anyway.
Ooh. Wow.
Zato is keeping those combos nice and basic, but it does good health.
Yeah, it does, yeah.
It takes some nice health. Oh, and little Eddie is out. Let's see if he's going to get his unblockable.
You know that EX Steel? Does that hit low?
Huh?
Does that EX Steel hit low?
I think so.
Right.
I think it does, yeah. I think you've got to sit down and then the unblockable comes where he throws
something.
But he throws
something,
yeah,
out.
Yeah.
Okay, because I got hit by that a few times, actually.
You know what? I don't even actually know why most Guilty Gear players find it more honourable to get blown up by Eddie, because it's just as disgusting, really.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. Oh, he had an opportunity to relaunch him there. That was nice.
Running, man. Nice.
Dr. No is looking to try and even this up a bit.
Oh,
oh wow.
That was the unblockable, right?
Yeah, and that's matched to Zato. Now this will actually be quite interesting. Yeah, you
actually can't move, yeah? You've got to play spawn driver again, yeah. Wait, driver! Wait, pawn driver! Pawn driver! You've got to play again. But wait, not too quick.
Yeah, so, alright, this is the grand final, and it's Pawn Driver versus Zato again.
Yeah, got some croissants.
Yeah, go on, go on.
What's up? What's up? Yeah. Quite safe, yeah? Right, yeah? My cool, bruv, still.
Oh, sorry about that. I don't know, I just got Shino shouting at me over there for some reason. Alright. So, so Zato is actually in losers, and Pawn Driver's in winners, so Zato has to win two sets. Yes, there is. Don't go, man. Yeah, all right, safe, bro. Safe, man. It's cool. I don't know anything about Tekken anyway.
Right.
I want to, but, you know.
Oh, shit. Gets a stun.
Yeah, he gets the gold burst. I think Zato has seen what's,
red.
What's happened.
Seen blood.
Yep. So that's 1-0 to Zato. I'm just interested, like, if there's going to be any character changes, because Pawn Driver also knows how to use
Slayer,
and Slayer's actually alright, so
yeah, Slayer's good.
If his Johnny does lose, it will be interesting to see if he changes. I think regardless, like, whatever happens, Zato will stay with Eddie, he will. Oh, wow. Divine Blade.
Yeah.
Oh, nice throw there. And he goes
for the mist.
Yeah, he goes for the mist. And he's going to try and get in there to make sure he can't do it to him.
Wow.
I actually thought there was going to be... Oh, wow. Oh, nice in Senga.
See the mist? If it hits, that's unblockable, right?
Yeah, if he does the mist, once he does the mist final, then it's unblockable.
Shit.
Yeah. Right. So, I mean, if he's level 2, like if he throws a coin at you and he gets level 2... missed final, then you want to avoid it because you know it's going to make you slide across the floor. He's going to dash in and pick you up with something. Johnny is a decent character. He's the one I actually... He was my first character in this game.
Very first one.
Yeah. And then as soon as Slash came out, which was a goddamn awful game, and I started to pick Port of Soul.
Right.
And then I felt robbed after a while, so I moved to Axel. Because like in Reload, like RZA and Robocop, they used to have a lot of fun with Axel. And he looks like a decent character as well, so why not?
Yeah.
You know? And he was good as well.
Hey, Obey. Obey. I beg you, commentate. I don't know what I'm looking
no,
at.
No, but you know he's not going to anyway, so... Look, he's
I
not,
don't really know
look.
What I'm looking at.
All right, well, look, look, look. I'll tell you what. Silence. That's right, you don't have to worry, man. At least Obey can admit it. He will just start burying. That's what Obey's going to be. You know? Yeah. Okay. So Zato is one matchup anyway. And he seems to have changed up his tactics ever so slightly. Pawn Driver put him into losers a couple of matches ago, so he's not going to want to make that mistake again. Gets the air throw. And he's got him in the corner as well, so let's see if... Wow. A lot of uppercuts there and a lot of health. Oh, a lovely uppercut there. And that's two matches to Zato, so he's reset the bracket. I definitely think if Pawn Driver loses this match, he might switch to Slayer. See if his Slayer can do any better against Eddie. Zato has definitely upped his game here. Ah, and he had to burst. He wanted none of that. He might have been a little bit smarter to hold on to the burst and maybe just lose the round. But he wants to try his best to fight, and he's taking off a lot of health there. Misses the Nsenga. Oh, wow. Pawn Driver's making a lot of mistakes here now. And that's it. A little bit panicky here. Yeah, I think so, yeah.
I think some of the people are having sessions.
Yeah. He's on level 2 Mistfinder now. Let's see if he can... Nah, he had an opportunity there to hit him down, but he never took it. Zato's doing a good job now, keeping his distance. He's putting Pawn Driver under a lot of pressure. Now he's got him in the corner. Yeah. And he goes for the unblockable and he gets it. And Pawn Driver now has his burst, so he has an opportunity, but I think he's going to hold on to it now. Even though he's got no real reason to, but he gets another uppercut and that's it. That's... So Zato's in the lead now, and no, he's staying with Johnny. I think he feels that he can do a lot more damage if he concentrates with him. And he can. He actually did quite well against Zato in the beginning, but now Zato's just taking him to pieces right now. Immediate burst. Doesn't want any of that unblockable business. He gets the level 2 Mistfinder. Oh, he drops the combo though. Oh, wow. And he's made that mistake. Let's see what happens. I think Zato's going to go for an unblockable. Yes, he does. But, oh, he drops the combo there. And Zato bursts as well. Zato playing very smart now. He actually put little Eddie away so he couldn't hit him with the coin. And he misses his throw. And Zato capitalizes on it and throws him back. It's a match point to Zato now. Gets the uppercut and he's losing a lot of health now. Again. Zato being smart. Keeping his distance. And now he's got Johnny into the corner. Let's see if he's going to call out a little Eddie and go for the unblockable. No. Goes for the jackhound. Wow. Level 2 misfire now. Gets the combo. He can pull this round back. He doesn't want to get hit by too many more of those uppercuts. Oh, wow. And Zato takes it. Yeah, that's it, man. All right. Yeah. Porn driver actually wanted more. I want more. Okay, if you give me a second, guys, I'm just going to head on over and go and get the Marvel guys and see if they want to come over here and finish off. Nah, they will anyway, so it's cool. Otherwise... Hey, look. Huh? You'll see in a minute. Just give me a second. Wow, the immediate explosions. Hey, what's up, man? Oh, is your joystick tangled?